heart, love letter, love book, love story, Taylor Swift. Okay, that was kind of good. I love Taylor Swift, massive fan. Watermelon Sugar High, Harry Styles is probably the song I play the most during our sound checks when I was testing the sound at our shows when we were on tour in, oh my god, 2019, a lifetime ago. Something with yoga and working out. Yeah, blood and devil, or bad blood, baby. Now we got bad blood. Good and bad.
Wait, something with heaven and hell then.
Good.
Oh,
feeling good is hell. Blood, it isn't in my blood. Is it? But in my, oh, like in my blood. Nice one. This must be High Horse, Casey Musgraves. I'm so excited to see Casey Musgraves one time live. I swear, we will go with the band, we will get drunk, and we will see Casey Musgraves live. A song that sums up my teens. I'm kind of embarrassed to say this, but also not. Do you remember that song, Zac Efron, when he is running on the golf court in High School Musical, and there's just like a great moment of him looking into the water? It's talking about me, and I get in my head. It's been with me for a long time. The song up until now that I've been the most happy with, I mean, I hope I still haven't written my favorite song. That's always what I try to go into the studio, but either Strangers, because Strangers have given me so much life and joy, and it is probably my favorite song to play live. It's pulsating, it's so fun. But I think lyrically, Don't Kill My Vibe is still the most important reminder to myself, because I do listen to Don't Kill My Vibe sometimes. I do listen to my own songs to get reminded of like what I can do and trust in myself and just remember what I'm doing.
The song that I would listen to after a breakup is probably one of my own. Probably a song like Don't Feel Like Crying. But I would probably listen to some Lizzo. Good as Hell or Juice. I would definitely listen to some Ariana Grande. Thank You Next. Sessions. That one too. The song that reminds me most of home, definitely something of Neil Young or Joni Mitchell. That's my parents' two of their favorite artists. At least my dad, he's a massive Neil Young fan. I would say Tell Me Why by Neil Young. It's not been released that many times, but there's like some weird live recording that we listen to a lot at home.
Something with a devil and a man who is sad. No, Bad Guy? Billie Eilish? Oh, I'm so competitive, this is great. Some files that look like office-y.
Is this a UK thing?
Oh, driver's license! Olivia Rodrigo. okay, there's two times here. 4 and 5, working night? Night, no.
1 hour, first place,
1 hour, gold. Golden hour. Golden hour? I thought of Harry Styles golden, but of course, golden hour, Casey Musgraves. 'Cause you're my golden.